create and edit posts, we'll look into creating categories and tags. Let's start with categories. Every post in WordPress is filed under one or more categories. Categories allow you the classification of your posts into groups and subgroups, thereby helping your visitors navigate and use your website. Each category may be assigned to a category parent so that you may set up hierarchy within the category structure. Using cars as an example, a hierarchy might be car as the parent category, Toyota as the child category, and Camry as the child category of the previous child category. When creating categories, remember that each category name must be unique regardless of hierarchy. When using the WordPress 2011 theme, all the categories to which a given post belongs to are displayed under that post. When someone viewing your blog clicks on one of those category links, an archive page with all the posts belonging to that category will be displayed in reverse chronological order. As you saw in the previous video, categories can be created when creating new posts, but you can also create and manage your categories from the categories page. The post categories page allows you to edit, add, and delete categories, as well as organize your categories into hierarchies. You can get there by clicking on categories in your post submenu in the main navigation. To add a new category, simply enter a name, a slug, which will be the URL to the archive page, or you can leave it blank and WordPress will automatically add one for you based on the category name you chose. Add a description if you like. This is an optional field and it only displays on some themes. Click on Add Category to create your new category. As you saw in the previous video, WordPress also allows you to create hierarchies among your categories. This helps to further organize your content. Let me show you how you can add a child category. Using the marketing category as our example, a child category might be copywriting. I'll type in copywriting as a title, and I will allow WordPress to automatically generate the permalink for me. Then I will choose marketing as the parent category. Once I click on Add New Category, you will see that my new category appears under its parent category, with a hyphen before the category name, indicating that this is a child of the category above it. Just as with the old post page, you can hover over each individual category to get a new set of links that provide you with options to edit, quick edit, delete your category. The edit link allows you to edit all the options of your category, while the quick edit link only allows you to edit the name and slug of your category. Since I have no need for the uncategorized category, I'm going to change the name and the slug to something more useful for my blog. I would recommend that you do the same if you're not going to use the uncategorized category. Keep in mind that you also have the option to bulk delete multiple categories by simply checking the boxes of the categories you want to delete and selecting Delete under the Bulk Actions drop-down menu, and then click Apply. If I want to display more or less categories per page, click on the screen options, then change the number of categories displayed per page to any other number you would like, and click Apply. This is not going to make any difference for me now since I only have a few categories, but if I had 50 or more, you would see the difference. Besides grouping posts into different categories, you have the option to assign different tags or keywords to further organize your post. Tags, just as categories, are a type of taxonomy or an organizational tool that you can add to any post you want. The difference is that tags are not required and they cannot be organized into hierarchies. In the 2011 theme, tags are also displayed below each post as links next to the categories. Clicking on any of these tags will take us to an archive page containing all the posts assigned to this tag. The tags panel is where you can create and manage your tags. This is located under Posts in the main navigation, right under Categories. On the left side of your Post Tags page, you will see a tag cloud, which is a list of your tags and displays the more popular tags in a larger font. The Tags panel works very much like the Categories panel. To add a new tag, simply enter a name for your tag, and then enter a slug or have one automatically generated by WordPress. Then, enter a description if you like. This is also not required. Just as with categories, you can apply bulk actions. And hover over each individual tag to reveal links for more options. I will not go through them since they are virtually the same as the category options. Now that you know how categories and tags work, we're going to move on to creating pages.